Hey y'all, welcome to my channel, Plant-Based Storm. I'm Stormy, and today I'm going to be sharing a recipe for a creamy roasted red pepper pasta sauce. And not only am I going to be sharing the recipe for that, I'm also going to be going over different types of calorie density and how I think about food whenever I'm making a recipe, specifically for my caloric needs at that particular moment in my life. So I'll be going over the indulgent version, the moderate version, and the lightened up version at the end of the recipe. So be sure to stick around so that you can see that. And please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and give me a thumbs up on this video if you like it. It really helps for other people to find this content. And let's just go ahead and jump right into the recipe.
So I'm getting the bulk of the sauce ready by preparing the vegetables, and I'm going to do that by roasting them in the oven at 350 for 30 to 40 minutes, depending on how roasted you like them. So this is 3 bell peppers cut up and an onion, just roughly cut, and then 7 cloves of garlic, and you can put as much as you want to in there. And then I'm going to give a big drizzle of balsamic vinegar and pop this into the oven, and also put a little bit of pepper on there. And then I'm just going to go ahead and boil this whole bag of noodles following the directions on the package, and I'm wanting to do it till it's al dente. And then I'm also cooking these mushrooms. I'm just dry sauteing them with a little bit of pepper. I'm going to put the lid on, let all of the liquid come out of the mushrooms, and then once that happens, and you can see how it's kind of left some brown bits on the pan, you can take a dry white wine and put in there. But I'm actually using a white wine vinegar because I didn't have any white wine on hand, and then just deglaze the pan, and it still has that nice crisp taste that you get with a white wine using the vinegar. So just whatever you'd like to, it's your choice. And then, like I said, I'm getting the noodles ready, and I'm going to cook them until they are al dente. So while these are cooking up, I'm going to go ahead and get the rest of the sauce ready. I lost a little bit of footage somehow of me taking it out of the oven, but this is basically what it looks like. It's already in the blender, just roasted nicely. And then I'm adding in a half a cup of cashews that I had soaking all day earlier, so that it would be easier to blend up. And then this is the oat milk from Trader Joe's, and I'm going to add in a cup of that to make it a little bit creamier. You can use whatever type of plant milk that you like, but I find that oat milk does help with the creaminess. And then I'm squeezing in half a lemon for a little zippy tang taste. And then you just mix it up. Now, if you have a better blender than I do, it's probably going to come out a lot creamier. This is the Ninja, but it still comes out really, really nicely. And so I like to take it, and I'm just going to add in the cooked noodles. And this is the reason I like to do it al dente, is because I'm going to add it into my pan, and then the sauce on top along with all of the other ingredients, and then just get it nice and warm and heated so that it tastes delicious and it's ready to serve. Have it a delicious roasted red pepper creamy sauce that is wonderful over a pasta. I hope that you enjoyed this recipe. Let's jump right into the calorie density. So there's a lot of different things that you can do. What the version you just saw was what I consider a indulgent version, because it was the cashews, plant milk, and noodles. There was still a plenty of vegetables in the sauce, but to make it more moderate, you could use a cauliflower puree with plant milk or water and then the noodles. The cauliflower puree would replace the cashew cream, and you would use the same proportion. So I used a half a cup of cashews, you would use half a cup of cauliflower puree, and then the 1 cup of plant milk or water to lighten the calories further. And then if you wanted a very light version, then you could do the cauliflower puree with the water or plant milk, plus you could do some type of noodle replacement where you use 50% of the regular noodles and then use like zucchini noodles or some other type of vegetable mixed in with that, and that will automatically lighten up the dish. So with all of these, the indulgent, moderate, and light, add a side salad or start it with a low calorie density soup, and that is going to further lighten up the calorie density by cutting your calories in half, but you're still going to be able to eat the same volume of food.
So I hope that you enjoyed that recipe. This is one of our favorites of late. It is super easy to make and it is delicious as well. So let me know what version you're going to try in the description box below. And as always, thanks so much for watching.